Hello and welcome to the review of TCL65C815 4K Ultra HD TV from 2020 TV lineup. I tested the 65-inch version, but the C81 series is also available in 55 and 75 inches. There are several videos already published on my channel covering different aspects of this TV, from picture quality to the review of its Android TV platform. So in this video, I'll summarize my experience after testing and using this TV for a few weeks. Let's get started! TCL expanded its QLED line with C71 and C81 series at CES 2020 in January and launched them across Europe in May. Both series are part of TCL's QLED line, which means they are equipped with quantum dot technology that can display wide color gamut that you can see on selected Ultra HD Blu-ray discs and streaming services. In addition, TVs support both Dolby Vision and HDR10 Plus dynamic metadata standards, along with HDR10 and HLG. On the audio front, Dolby Atmos is supported. 60Hz panels are installed in the entire C71 series and in the 55-inch version of C81 series, while the 65 and 75-inch C81 are equipped with true 120Hz panels. C71 is using direct LED and C81 edge LED backlight, but neither have a true local dimming technology implemented to control individual zones of the screen. Even though both C71 and C81 feature slim metal design, the C81 is bulkier in the bottom area. But there is a good reason for that. C81 has an integrated Onkyo 2.1 soundbar system with front-firing speakers and rear woofer. The soundbar is permanently attached to the TV, whether you install it on its legs or hang it on the wall. C81 is also more friendly for narrow furniture, as its legs aren't as wide as the screen itself, but definitely ensure a big enough surface. On my narrow stand, each of the three legs was just a few centimeters away from the edge, so I was a bit worried since there is an increased earthquake activity in Southeast Europe this year. I would definitely recommend placing this TV on a bigger surface. All physical connectors are side-facing and they include 3 HDMI's 2.0b, 2 USB's 2.0, antenna and satellite inputs, Toslink, Ethernet, analog input via the supplied adapter and 3.5mm headphone jack. TV also has built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Familiar 2 remote controls are supplied with this TV, one standard remote with a total of 45 buttons and a more compact smart remote with 20 buttons and built-in microphone. Both remotes have Netflix buttons, so you can directly open this app even if the TV is in standby. Remotes fit nicely in hand, have a good layout, and were working perfectly fine during the test. Apart from one microphone built in the smart remote, there is another one in the TV itself. It can be activated by saying OK Google, as I demonstrate in my hands-on review of the Android TV platform. C81 series comes with Android TV 9. It has built-in Google Chromecast and Google Assistant, and all the apps you could think of thanks to the Google Play Store. As on previous TCL TVs, there are no issues with the stability of the platform, but there are some downsides. The first one is too long boot time, by default almost 40 seconds for the TV to become responsive. This can be improved in settings, but as a downside, some apps will not function properly, like informing you that TV is not connected to the internet, even though it is. The second one is stuttering in streaming apps and media players. In movies, even with all the motion algorithms disabled, you could notice frames being skipped from time to time, and for me this is distracting. The situation gets worse with demanding 4K 60 content on YouTube that can even turn into a slideshow. I really hope TCL will address this with an update soon. C81 performs well in the picture quality department. Colors and grayscale are very accurate in movie picture mode for both SDR and HDR, upscaling is decent, and the TV handles well all types of signal. Thanks to its 120Hz screen and good uniformity, it can display more details in motion, which is great for sports. Another advantage is wide color gamut, which will show off deeper colors in certain HDR content. The TV is based on a 120Hz VA panel with direct LED backlight, and this combination achieves ANSI contrast of over 4000 to 1. There is no local dimming technology implemented, so contrast can't be further improved. Peak brightness is below 350 nits, which in combination with a semi-glossy screen means that you will probably need to adjust ambient lighting to see all content on the screen, for example during a sunny day. Viewing angles are narrow, so you need to sit directly in front of the screen or under a small angle to see the highest contrast and color saturation. You can separately adjust blur and judder reduction in picture settings. In other words, you can adjust the amount of details in motion and intensity of soap opera effect. There is also black frame insertion technology that did further improve motion resolution. But it's got side effects such as flickering, doubling of objects and reduction of brightness, so I kept it turned off. Variations of brightness depending on average picture level or how bright or dark the picture is was an issue until the latest update, after which the TV was not doing this automatically in SDR and HDR. The exception is Dolby Vision content, where this effect is still activated, but unofficially I was told this will be also corrected in a future update. Sound quality is definitely above average in terms of clarity and bass response, and I would say many people will not consider an external audio system next to these speakers. Vocals sound natural and there is enough bass to add warmth and richness to the music. Of course, for the best movie watching experience, I would always recommend an external audio system, like the one I used in this test. I was using Marantz NR1710 AV receiver and 5.2 speaker system, which in combination with this 65-inch screen gave a really nice home theater experience. Gamers will get a game mode on this TV with input lag between 21 and 24 milliseconds, which is very good but not excellent as competitors are below 15 milliseconds for quite some time now. There is no auto low latency mode, age, GIG or FreeSync support, but still I had a good time playing games on this TV. Since the ports are not HDMI 2.1, you will get a maximum resolution of 2160p at 60Hz. Okay, time to wrap up this review. TCL did a good job with C81 series. It offers strengths I've seen on previous models, such as elegant metal design, built-in soundbar, two remote controls, very good picture quality, plenty of controls for adjustment, and all the benefits of Android TV platform. On the other hand, slow boot time and issues with playback in video apps is something that TCL should improve quickly, as competitors don't have such issues, and their TVs come from standby in a matter of seconds. That's the reason why I cannot give my absolute recommendation to this TV, even though it's got all the right ingredients for it. If you're looking for a TV with lower input lag, FreeSync, auto low latency mode, HGIG, EARC and faster operating system with no playback issues, then I recommend the Samsung Q70T series in this price category. And this is it, let me know what you think about this TV and which would you pick in this price category. I would like to thank Agram Service for sending me this TV for testing and to retail shop Ronis for sending me Marantz NR1710 AV receiver to check ARC connectivity. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video.